The table shows the number of registered weapons and the murder rate for several states, where X equals thousands of automatic weapons and Y equals the number of murders per 100,000 residents. We want to create a scatter plot on the calculator and then determine a linear model for the data. We want to round to the hundredths place value. So to enter the data, we'll press stat, enter. If we have old data in here, we can go to the top of the column, press clear, enter to clear the entire column. We'll enter the row of X values in the first column and the row of Y values in the second column. You can right arrow to L2 and enter in the Y values. It is worth double checking these values because if one of them is incorrect, we will get the wrong equation. To create the scatter plot, we're going to press second Y equals and turn this first plot on. So we'll press enter. When the cursor is blinking on, we'll press enter. Everything else is set correctly. Now we do have to adjust the window. We've done a couple of these by hand, but we also have the option of pressing zoom stat. So if we press zoom and then scroll down to number 9, we can press zoom stat and it will adjust the window automatically. So there's our data, and we can see from the data a linear model is going to be a good fit for this data. So now we'll determine the line of best fit. We'll press stat, right arrow, then option 4 for linear regression, where A is the slope and B is the y-intercept. So we'll press enter and then enter again. Now we want to round to the hundredths, so we're going to use a slope of 0.83 and a y-intercept of 4.02. So let's go ahead and write this down. Remember, X represents thousands of automatic weapons and Y represents the number of murders per 100,000 residents. Let's go ahead and graph this right on top of the scatter plot. So we'll press Y equals and then type in our equation. And press graph. And we can see this line is an excellent fit for the given data. Now using this equation, let's answer some questions. We want to know how many murders per 100,000 residents can be expected in a state with 5.6 thousand automatic weapons. And since X is in thousands of weapons, we'll substitute X equals 5.6 into our equation and then determine Y. And Y will be the number of murders expected per 100,000 residents. So we'll have Y equals 0.83 times 5.6 plus 4.02. Of course, we could do this by hand, but since we already have the equation in the calculator, let's go ahead and use the calculator. So if we go back to the home screen, second mode, and then press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, this will bring up Y1, and then in parentheses, we can just type in 5.6. And this should remind you of function notation. Notice how we are asked to round to 3 decimal places, but we have 3 decimal places. So we have 8.668, which would be the approximate number of murders per 100,000 residents in the state. For the last question, we want to know how many murders per 100,000 residents can be expected in a state with 10.8 thousand automatic weapons. So it's the same question, but this state has more automatic weapons. So we'll have Y equals 0.83 times 10.8 plus 4.02. I'm going to go ahead and go back to the calculator. So now we'll press vars, right arrow, enter, enter, and then in parentheses 10.8. And so now we can expect 12.984 murders per 100,000 residents. And let's go ahead and label the units down here. This would be murders per 100,000 residents. And here as well.